Coming up, we look at updates to Microsoft Teams for first-line workers and their managers across industries, including a customizable mobile experience for first-line workers that's configurable by IT using the updated Admin Center. New mobile features relevant to first-line workers, such as a new smart camera, the ability to record and share audio, your location, and much more, and the shifts capability that enables managers to easily build shift schedules, share daily goals, corporate content, and also enables employees to easily review shifts and make shift change requests. So I'm joined today by Keara James for Microsoft Teams. Welcome.
Thank you, Jeremy. It's a pleasure to be here.
So first-line workers, they really make up a huge part of the workforce. We recently had General Manager Lori Wright on the show highlighting our focus in this area. But what's specific about their needs and what are we trying to deliver here with Microsoft Teams?
So despite there being over 2 billion first-line workers globally, traditionally, this area of the workforce has been underserved. From sales associates in retail stores to warehouse workers in factory floors, these are the people that are first with products and to perform services, first to engage with customers, and first to represent a company's brand. But first-line workers often face unique challenges with fragmented technology. They often feel disconnected from their team and company. They're using obsolete and outdated tools, and it's often hard for them to receive information and content. And for managers of first-line teams, this places more burden on them to keep everyone on the same page. And they have to make sure that they're staffed to meet the needs of the business.
Right, and this is something that we've all seen before. When there's a technological gap or a need, people just find a way, right? They use maybe consumer apps or other things to stay connected. We can all relate to these kind of challenges, I think, because I was a barista for 7 years through high school and through college, so I know what it's like to not have all the tools and technology to really help me.
Same. I've been a retail worker and I've had to deal with some really antiquated processes. So our focus is really to reverse this trend, put these workers first, and address these challenges with Microsoft Teams.
Okay, I know one of the biggest pain points, whether you're a manager or a first-line worker, is really managing shifts and understanding your shift schedule.
It is. In fact, shift scheduling is foundational to the first-line experience. As a first-line worker, you're heavily dependent on your schedule and when you have to be at work. With shifts, managers can easily plan and distribute shift schedules, and team members can easily review shift schedules from their mobile device.
Right, and this is one of those often paper-based processes. You might have a whiteboard or something in your break room, and it's really hard to stay up to date. When changes are made, they might get even lost.
Exactly. Shifts alleviates a lot of that stress and is available by default in your tenant. You can access it in your overflow menu on web and desktop, and on your mobile device, you can access it on your navigation bar.
So let's start with the manager experience first on your PC, then we'll move over to my phone and the first-line worker experience.
Of course. So here's the shift schedule I've built out for Contoso Electronics Store. As you can see here, there are 5 different departments. And one thing I really want to call out are open shifts. Mm-hmm. Open shifts are available for my team to take at will because they're not individually assigned to anybody. There are optional day notes here at the top of the schedule, and these notes are shared with everyone on the team. And in this case, I've added our sales forecast goals, but you can use this space to communicate anything. For example, a heads up that a district manager is coming to visit the store.
Okay, that's great. So tell me more about how a manager can actually start to schedule and assign some of these shifts to first-line workers.
So it looks like Joanna is available on Saturday, and because I'm expecting a lot of foot traffic this weekend, I want to add a shift to her schedule. Mm-hmm. What you'll notice here is the opportunity to customize the start and end times. I can color code the shift with different colors based on my preference, and I can replace the start and end times with a label if I want to.
Okay.
Now, what I really want to do are add responsibilities for Joanna for her shift. I can simply add that in shift notes. And then lastly, I'll add an activity like a break or lunch. And I'm going to save that. What you'll notice is that this edit is in italics, which means that it's still in edit mode. I can decide to share this edit with everybody on my team or only the affected people.
So now you have a mechanism really to build a schedule that's always up to date. So all those changes as they happen, they're in real time for anyone who's consuming these shifts, which is really cool. It looks really easy to use as a manager.
It is. You can easily copy and paste shifts with Control-C and Control-V and other keyboard shortcuts. You can easily move different rows up and down, which makes it really easy to customize that experience for the manager. And one of the more powerful capabilities we've added is the opportunity to copy forward a schedule, either at a day, week, or month at a time. You can include or exclude shift notes, time off, activities, and open shifts.
Right, this will save a lot of people a lot of time.
Exactly. And for example, if I have a schedule that's in 4-week rotations, I can make this really easy and share that information with my team.
Very cool. So it looks really easy in terms of schedule management, getting everything up and running, but how easy is it for me as a manager then to share content out with my team?
You can do everything in Teams. All your team members are connected, and Teams is literally your communication and collaboration hub. So let's go into the Teams experience. What you'll notice here are the different channels that are part of the Contoso Electronics store. I recently heard on a Teams meeting that there's a new update to our bonus structure. And to ensure my team is up to date, I'm going to share that information with them via stream. I'm going to add a video, search for the video, and I want to post to the channel about this new tab. And that stream uploads into the Teams experience with a really rich playback. On top of being able to listen to the video while in Teams, I can search for different things within the video. And remember when I mentioned bonuses earlier? Well, I can find that mark where it was mentioned by simply searching, and there we have it. And this is no doubt something my team would be interested in. So I'm going to leave them a message so that they can check out the 6-minute mark.
So this is a really great overview of the manager experience, but why don't we switch gears and have a look at my experience on the phone as a first-line worker. So in my case, one of the greatest things here with this is I can actually get to all the content. I've got a custom experience here for my team that you can see on the bottom of the screen. And I've even got a nice tray with additional functionality like the camera and other capabilities within that that I can even personalize if I want to as a user. So it makes it very customized for my own role and my own experiences. Now, one of the great things with Teams is you can actually share files as you just saw. And if I go into my overall view of all the different teams and channels I've got, I'm going to go ahead and go into onboarding first, because this is what's something really important, especially if I'm a new hire into the team. And I can see my employee handbook, checklist, brand values, all of those great items that I can do to get up to speed with the organization I'm in. And if I go into the general tab, here's where I can actually see that you've just posted the video that you just posted, the files there as well. If I click on more, I'll even see the tab. And when I click on that, it's going to actually open up for me that video straight from stream. And I can even play that right here on the mobile phone. So I've got all the access that you have on your PC, but on my mobile device in this case, to be able to consume everything you've shared with me. Now, all of the different files, everything are here. And I can also get to, if I go back into Teams, I can also get to all of my shifts. And here I can see all the different shifts that I'm scheduled to work on. If I click into one of those, I can see the shift notes. I can see it looks like there's a product replacement going on that I need to be aware of, and also the day notes. So I have all of that information. And because I'm in Teams, it's a great place to be able to do chat. So here I can go ahead and start up a chat with Nestor. And here, whether I want to type with Nestor, I can do that and type him a message. I can also, if I want, set up a video chat with him. So here I've got a nice ability to call Nestor and do a face-to-face chat, and all of this straight from my team's experience on my phone. Something brand new though, and showing more integration across the various Microsoft and Office 365 capabilities, the ability to annotate images. So let me show you something brand new here. So in my case, I'm gonna go ahead and share a photo with Nestor to make sure that we're replacing the right product on the shop floor. So we can see it's a mini DisplayPort HDMI adapter. And I'm going to go ahead and flip that over because I need the information actually about the item number. So I'll go ahead and take the photo of that. And now because I've got inking support here with this, I can actually annotate the image. So I'll go ahead and I'll turn the blue pen on. I can look at the SKU number and make sure that's the right one from the notes that needs to be replaced with a newer model, or see if it is the new model on the floor. So I'll go ahead and hit check. And now I can share that with Nestor just to make sure. Another great thing is if I'm on the shop floor, a lot of times I only have one hand free, so I can actually even record a message for him. Hey Nestor, is this the right item I need to replace from the shop floor? And now he'll be able to get that message and I don't have to type anything on my phone.
Exactly, and it's good to be able to get help quickly. And should they not be able to answer right now, they can listen to it on demand later.
Right, one more part here that I need to actually do as part of this replacement is make sure that we get a replacement part sent from a nearby supplier. So to do that, I'm gonna go into my Teams view. I'm going to go and look on the inventory chat team. And here in this case, I actually want to share the location of our store to make sure they can actually come to us and give us a replacement part. So this is something that we use in the past with this channel. So here I'm going to go ahead and click on the ellipses here. I'll see location. Now that's going to use GPS and actually triangulate my location. So I'll select that. And now I have the ability to send that out to make sure that my supplier can make it to my store.
This could be really helpful when you have to keep track of a lot of moving parts.
Totally. So something else that's brand new here is the ability also to use the smart camera. In this case, I've got a crumpled receipt here from a customer that wants to return an item. And I can see here that if I select document, it's actually going to use some of the capabilities within Office Lens to be able to straighten this crumpled paper out and actually crop it down to a nice straight image. And I can see the text very cleanly and very easily. And now that can be shared out with my team. In this case, I'm going to share it out with the North store. And then they will have that receipt to be able to save in their records.
And the best part about it is that the image isn't stored locally on the device.
Right. And the great thing is if I go into my gallery in the local device, you can see I've got some images here maybe for my social media activities, but I don't have the picture of that receipt. So I might have customer information, so it's kept secure.
Exactly.
So one of the other great things here as well is I can do one of the biggest pain points and challenges that I remember even when I was working as a barista, swapping shifts with people and my colleagues. So here in this case, I know on Monday I've got a doctor's appointment, so I want to go ahead and go into my shift there and swap. So here I can see all my different team members that are available, and it's nice because it's queried those down to the folks that can actually work during that shift. And I'm going to ask my friend Alex here if he'll swap with me, let him know that I've got a doctor's appointment. Now when I go and ask for that shift swap, it's going to actually ask Alex in this case and our manager to approve that request.
Yeah, it's awesome that you have this new capability. Let's swing back over to my device so I can show you one final thing. Now, as a manager, I can share my appreciation for a job well done. You can share a badge with your teammates and colleagues. I'm going to select the coaching badge. I want to recognize Deborah because she helped mentor Diego during his shift. I'll add a quick note. I'll be able to preview that badge, and I can just simply hit send. Now, everybody is aware of the job well done for Deborah.
Great stuff. So that's a really rich manager and first-line worker set of connected experiences. But now as a Teams user, I know that there are also a broader set of experiences that I could have seen as well, and that IT plays a role in terms of customizing and tailoring those experiences in terms of what I can see.
Exactly. And now with our new customizable Teams mobile experience, IT admins have the opportunity to apply a prepackaged policy or apply some of their own custom policies. What you'll do is navigate to the Teams and Skype for Business Admin Center, and under the Teams drop-down menu, you can select App Setup Policies. If I wanted to create a new custom one, I'd add that under New Policy, but I already have some set up, so let's just dive into those. First, I'll check out our cashier's policy. What you'll see here is an experience tailored to them. I'll simply just want to move up shift so that's more easily accessible, and I'll hit Save.
Now, this is going to customize kind of the bottom tray experience as to what icons I see and what functionality I have.
Right. And what I want to show you is the manager experience. Managers aren't on shift, so they don't have that ships capability. However, they do have to approve and validate lots of things.
Makes sense.
So I want to add a third-party app, Approve Simple, and add that to the navigation menu. I'll hit Add, save it, and in a couple hours, they'll see that pop up.
All right, so this is a really great overview in terms of all the new first-line worker capabilities from Teams, from the manager side to the end-user experience or the first-line worker, all the way to what IT can do to customize those experiences. But where can I go to learn more?
Get started using Microsoft Teams. If you have Office 365, it's included in many of the suites, and you can start with Teamwork and the admin controls. You can also get the mobile apps from the App Store and Google Play.
Thank you, Keara. Of course, keep watching Microsoft Mechanics. Hit subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time, and goodbye for now.